So our next congresswoman has an event in Tucker, so we want to try to get on a schedule here. Y'all heard of Karen Handel, right? Pop a little loud for the next congresswoman. All right, Karen. Already polling in first place against okay, well, cool. That was a good way to get people to the seats, isn't it? I'm going to go and turn it over to Angela, and we'll go ahead and get
the next
one.
Good morning, everybody.
Morning.
How are y'all?
Great.
All right, well, out of deference for our candidate who is on the trail and hitting the ground running, going all over the district today, why don't we recognize Karen Handel and let her rally the troops, because we've got a lot of work to do and we need all of y'all out campaigning this weekend, so please give it up for Karen Handel.
All right, thank you so much. You know, I want to start off by saying thank you, because this is the first Fulton breakfast since the April 18th election, and I know I saw Bob Gray here. Let's give him a big round of applause. Thank you very much for making it a good competitive race. I was talking with some on that. One of the big differences between Democrats and Republicans, they believe in coronations, we believe in competition, so I think that is right on. I was told by Roger Wise to do something first, and, well, like most of you in the room, it makes me a little nervous not to do what Roger tells me, so I'm going to do it. So if this is a hat from President Trump, make America great again. Amen. I'm going to pull the number out, and Angeline, I'm going to need your younger eyes over here to read the number.
I'll read the last four digits, 3310. 3310.
No one? Oh. Yeah. Oh, yeah, all right. All right, are we pulling another one? All right, one more.
3301.
Is this a trick? Roger, are there any real numbers in here?
Just move it down. These numbers only started this morning.
Hey, Roger,
here we go.
Read it again. 3301.
3301.
All
right.
Thank you, ladies.
Thank you very much. All right, let's do a quick state of the race. First of all, folks, we are closing the enthusiasm gap. Wherever I go, Republicans are energized and ready to go. We know what is at stake on June 20th. This is a great crowd today, and I know how hard every one of you is working for me and for the Republican Party. And please know that I am working equally as hard to make sure that we do our jobs to bring home this election on June 20th. A couple of things to kind of go through. It's already been, whoever the they are out there, they have declared this race the most expensive race in the history of congressional races in the country. So we can expect anywhere from $40 million to $50 million to be spent on this race. I frankly find it obscene, but it is the playing field. And just know that from a money front, we are going to be just as competitive. Money is coming in great. It's kind of interesting that the little engine that could, the Handel campaign, I now have a distinction at holding a fundraising record. The irony of that is not lost on me. But the most important thing is making sure that we execute flawlessly coming into June 20th. When does early voting start?
8:30
a.m. Yes, yes. And we need to put as many votes in the bank in early voting as possible. We are now, at least in Fulton County, and I believe in DeKalb, I'm not sure about Cobb yet, there are going to be not one, but 2 days of Saturday voting. Look for our campaign, hopefully the 6th District and each of the counties will also do, through your GOP, a very robust effort to get as many people out to vote as possible. Now, whenever there is this much money, and you have George Soros coming in and playing for John Ossoff, they have a lot of money to spread around a bunch of lies. So number one, y'all know I didn't buy a car on state money, right? Come on. The Secretary of State's office had a car allowance, so that's number one. Number two, a trip. I have the great honor of being asked by Governor Sonny Perdue to be a member of his delegation on an economic development trip to China. So those things, don't believe all of this stuff. We're putting up a little micro website that everybody can go to if you have friends or neighbors who are asking about it so that you can get all of the facts. Tuesday, watch the television Tuesday and watch your emails. We will launch our TV ad on Tuesday. I think you'll like it a lot. I'm really, really proud of it. It's gonna be great. And I hope some of you saw the little snippet about Steve in the paper today. Yes, they talked about his hole in one. Any man's dream to have his hole in one mentioned in the paper. All right, there is one other election that is coming up that is equally as important as this one. And it is on Tuesday to get this woman right here, Kate Kirkpatrick, elected. The energy, if you are in that state senate district, the energy that you feel for me, please, please put that behind Kay, because let me tell you what will happen. She needs to win and win big for the legislature, because that is a crucial vote in terms of the numbers, the majority that will hold in the state senate. But equally as important, make no mistake about it, the Democrats are going to be watching that race as a bellwether to what might happen in the 6th district race. So know that I'm gonna be beating the bushes for Kay. We need every one of you doing that. I hope I'll see some of you on Monday at our rally with Speaker Ryan. It's gonna be great. Stay tuned. We know that Vice President Pence is coming. I can't give the date yet, but I will as soon as I can. I appreciate all of you so very much for your friendship, your love, and your prayers. God bless y'all.
Somebody has a gift for your husband that she wants to give to you to give to your husband.
This is my good friend Sandy here. I don't know what she's got up her sleeve, but you never know.
Well, we all know what a sharp dresser Steve Handel is. But he's currently missing something. And Steve. He needs it. So, Steve.
Mike. Go ahead, open the box and let her put them on her husband.
No, I'm going to let Sandy do the honors.
Okay. Put them on. Put them on and wear them with pride. Hey,
Sandy. Is this man a class act or what, y'all? Thank y'all. God bless.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Sandy, and thank you, Karen, for all that you do for our district, and we are all going to get out hard and work for you this weekend and over the next 4 or 5 weeks. All right, everybody, if you can come here and be at a breakfast, go door to door, or you can make phone calls to Karen Handel and Kay Kirkpatrick. I want to let Kay talk to y'all a little bit about her race, because it's coming up this Tuesday. So if you live in Senate District 32, Judson Hill's former district, we need you to vote. If you haven't voted yet, if you have, take your neighbors to the poll. And please, please, let's help get these two great women elected.